Matthew 5:13. Ye are the salt of the earth, but if the salt have lost its savour, wherewith shall it be salted? It is henceforth good for nothing, but be cast out to be trodden under the foot of men. Ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. You hear that? It giveth light unto all in the house. So, some of you might be taking solace on being on conference line every time. You say, give it light to all in the house. All in the house. That's a place of meeting. Light to all in the house. Ashallah, bragados. But where I'm going tonight, the Bible says, entertain ye are salt of the earth. You see, Jesus gave a very good demarcation here. Say, you are the salt of the earth and the light of the world. Salt is meant for the earth, light for the world. Two different things. Listen, gentlemen, we lack salters of the earth, and the earth is crying. Sheila Bragabush. Salt are the preservers of this earth. That's it. Because salt, of course, the property salt carries, it preserves. The earth needs preservation. Only salt can preserve it. Say, men, you are salt. How can God be calling men salt? Because God has placed upon you and I the power to preserve this earth. Salt are intercessors. Salt are prayer men and women who through their prayer and travail in prayer preserve this earth. Today, we lack preserve us. We're looking for them. That's why the earth is, of course, disjointed and losing foundation. Because intercessors are hardly found. Salt of the earth. It's not enough to be a light of the world. You're talking about light being a light in the cosmos. People who sit in darkness, you're a light to a system, to a people. What about the earth? By virtue of study of God's word, illumination and revelation of God's word, you become light. But salt, only few men are salt of the earth. Only few. As a matter of fact, I hear this word revolution everywhere, that we have enough illumination to carry dominion in the world and affect the cosmos. But where we're lacking men is in the salt realm. We're lacking preservers. And tonight, I'm talking about something very important, by the grace of God. God will help us. Amen.
Amen.
I declare, become preservers of the earth.
Amen.
Become preservers of the earth.
Amen.
Become preservers of the earth.
Amen.
Preservers of the earth.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
amen.
The earth, they will look for you.
Amen.
The earth will look for you.
Amen.
The earth will look for you. To preserve the integrity of this earth. God said only those who are sought can preserve it. I welcome you on board the realm of preservers.
Yes.
To keep this earth the way God has kept it. So that it will not lose its course. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
By grace of God, house clearing, we'll be going through a lot of process this week. This week our entry will be very powerful for all of us, by the grace of God, monthly, every month end. So ladies, I'm going to enter into 5-day marathon again, starting from Tuesday. Our three-day drive fast begins on Monday by 10 p.m. and ends on Thursday by 10 p.m. And 3-day drive fast, no food, no water. And then we begin our fiscal meeting on Tuesday, 7 to 9:30, throughout Saturday. Amen.
Amen.
7 to 9:30 to Thursday. Then on Friday, we are night vigil, 6:30 to 12:30 a.m. And on Saturday, we wrap it up. Amen. It's very, very, very rewarding. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And by the grace of God, don't miss this, the Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. We're looking at something very important. I want us to deal with that aspect. Who is behind this evil? So Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, we're dealing with that part. Who is behind this evil? Evil plaguing our nation, Nigeria, plaguing this country. Who is behind it? Plaguing people's lives and families. So I want us to be here for Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Let us deal with this evil, this thing. Somebody is behind something. Mm-hmm. Nothing just happens. Am I committed? So we're dealing with that the 3 days. We call it his mountain encounter, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Friday, went time to night with you. God will help us. And Saturday to be powerful. Some of us who are test us is longer than that. That's us. We're here to, we're going to be here tomorrow to pray for the foot of the, foot of the womb. Right, tomorrow, right?
Yes, sir.
Tomorrow we'll be here by 5. Is it okay? 5 o'clock? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So if you are believing God through the womb, or have someone, somebody trusting God through the womb, let's be here and pray together and touch his altar. Mm-hmm. Tomorrow we'll be here by 5. Praise God. And which is Sunday. Monday, Texas are having retreats. We'll be here again on Monday. So for Texas, it's about
8 days.
I use a slap as if he's part of it. I think going to fast this time, 3 days very fast. So it's your turn. Amen. Praise the Lord. So it's going to be, and then on Tuesday, Opa, we're going to be our Holy Ghost, Global Anointing Service. So it's all very loaded.
Yes, sir.
Very loaded. Are you excited about this week coming?
Yes, sir.
Huh. Thank you, Lord Jesus. It will be powerful. It's not possible for you to go through this and remain the same. It's not possible.
We must testify.
It's not possible. Because God is still there. It's the only truth. Nobody, they will try to hijack it, they kicked him out. Praise the Lord. The bond him and threw him out. They say, what to those in the earth and the sea? Even they say, what to those who are in the earth, but we have preservers. Yes, we will earth, sea, but there are preservers. That's why we need salts. Salt means, the Bible means, prayer men, intercessors, who can preserve. Praise the Lord. Say you are the salt of the earth. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Okay, that's the last hearing. So, we're not going to attack very quickly. Now, we begin this topic, we begin this series in month of August, understand the mysteries of a staying power. And by grace of God, we have dealt with different topics, and today going to be a part 3. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
The first day we talked about the marks of Christ, the marks. Second, sorry, part two, we talked about the glory. Tonight, by the grace of God, we look into what I call the waiting. Amen.
Amen.
Waiting. And we have heard this waiting over and over again. In fact, it's been overemphasized. And I was praying, Lord said, let's talk about the waiting. Especially as we're about to, it's timely as we're about to enter into 3-day fast. Let us understand what is this waiting? What is he talking about? You know. Amen.
Amen.
Waiting. Shakaba. Please, let's pay attention. Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, I begin to look at several things about our people, men, prophets, men of God, who have dealt or been with God at different times and seasons. I began to look at one of the secrets why they waited the power they did. The manner at which they walk was so fascinating. You'd be wondering why somebody would be far gone ahead and some of these men are still waiting. And when they come up on the scene, they supersede the best that have gone ahead of them. Why? What is this thing about this waiting thing? That people can decide to wait, but when they begin to move, they move faster, much, much faster than those who have gone ahead. What is this mystery behind it? Why should we wait? When the world is ravaged, full of rush through, rush hour, drive through, drive nose, drive everywhere is drive through. The word is when I'm driving on the road, I will see people speeding so fast that as if and it's so good that for no reason the red light just stop you with all your speed. It's such a mystery. One day I saw someone just pass me. Woo! I said, I would nearly say, take it easy. I saw, and let me keep my. I said, the red one will stop you over there. And truly, red light stopped him. Where are we rushing to? Amen. Amen. That's why I believe the coronavirus was meant to tell us,
slow down.
Take it easy. Getting too fast. Amen. Even at the rush to pharmacy, give me this in this drop, give me this. Even at the rush through, they're still rushing. At the rush through. Nobody wants to wait anymore. Praise God. The world is full of rush. What is this about this waiting? This rushing thing that we cannot even wait. Okay, let me start by. I went through, I tried to look at the dictionary meaning of waiting to start with that. Amen. Shakata. Dictionary meaning, what I saw dictionary was so wonderful. It says something here. I says this how dictionary defines it. But I have to write it out because I love what is there. It's a lot of some ingredients there. It says waiting is the action of staying. As if you knew we're talking about staying power. The action of staying where one is, not that way you are, you stay there. No move. The action of staying where one is. Or? Amen. Please, can you turn off that phone? That something. Who is that? Just go outside. Quickly rush outside. No, go outside.
We are listening to you.
No, but it's going to be recorded. So, no, it's recording. It's going to record. And delaying an action, let me start again, is an action of staying where one is. Or delaying an action until a particular time. Please mark this word. Or until something happens. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Please pay attention. I'll repeat it again because I want to get every thing. The dictionary defines so well that I got interested. Is the action of staying where one is. One, stay where you are, don't move. Two, delaying an action until a particular time. So time is involved. Staying is involved. Delay is involved. Until something happens, which means something must change, something must happen. To prove an effective waiting, there must be a change. Because basically it's waiting until something happens. So the change is what proves your waiting. So change is a resultant factor of waiting. So why would we not wait? If change will become the result of your waiting. Why would you not wait? Praise God. I thought they said delay is denial. In this case, delay is not denial. You are waiting for that appointed time until something happens. Job 14, okay, read one. 14, Job 14, 14. Let's read. Job 14, 14. Job, the book of Job, chapter 14, 14. Hallelujah. Do you have a microphone there?
Yeah. Praise the Lord.
Can you honey for her, please? As usual. Always honey for her. Only honey for give it to her. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If a man dies, will he live again?
Okay.
All the days of my heart service, mm-hmm. I will wait for my renewal to come. Praise the Lord.
All the days of what?
All the days of my heart service.
Heart service. That's that version. Can I have another version again? All the days of my heart service. So there's hardness involved. Hardness. Praise God. In fact, if you're not hard, you can't wait. You must be hard. Does it? Look at what the Bible shows you. Find it. How can I just stay in one place? They'll think you are sick. The Bible says, stay in one place. The act of staying, action, stay in one place. Don't move.
You still want another version?
Give another version. Eh?
If a man dies, shall he live again? All the days of my warfare, would I wait till my release shall come?
So this one says it's a warfare. You see, these are the ingredients of waiting. Number one tells you there is hardness in it. To wait is to be hard. It's not easy to wait. It's hardness. Number two says it's a warfare. It's a fight. It's already giving us the ingredients of waiting. So it's hard. That's how people don't want to wait. Always they hurry. Because to wait is to, you must be hard. To wait is a fight. Because everybody wants to move. Everybody wants to move. Everybody wants to move. In fact, one of the ways to punish children is to take their home from there and say, sit down one place. In fact, don't even beat them. Just tell them, sit down. Give your phone. Ah. Tell your mom, please beat me. I prefer to be beat. Praise God. It's not easy to wait. It's tough. It's difficult. That's why people find it difficult to wait. Amen. Another version, again, let's see what another version says.
People die, and they come back to life.
Okay.
That it will wait, but I will wait for the better times. Wait till this time of trouble is ended.
Okay. This one says that's a trouble. Okay, go ahead.
If a man died, shall he live again?
Okay.
All the days of my appointed time will I wait till my change comes.
Okay. All these are appointed time. So that's an appointed time. So which means waiting has an appointed time. That's an appointed time inside waiting. Amen. That's a period of waiting. So we see hardness, we see warfare, we see timing, we see troubles. So these are things that make people not to wait. They don't want to wait. Nobody wants to wait. Everybody's in a hurry. But the truth remains that if you don't go through the rigors of waiting, then the result will not be there. Result says change. I wait him as change comes. So that's why a lot of people don't have changes in their spiritual life, because they're not waiting. If you don't wait, there's no change. You are doing the same thing over and over again. In fact, people are defining insanity as somebody do the same thing over and over again, get the same result. That's insanity. Do the same thing over and over again, expecting a different result. Is that not madness? But change, wait tells you that if you wait, there is hardness, there is warfare, there is trouble, there is timing, there is time involved, time frame involved. So if you do all this, at the end of the day, there will be change. Change is coming your way. Change is coming your way. As you enter these 7 days as you like, and then 3-day dry fast, change will come your way. Change will come your way. I said change will come your way. You will get result. You will get result. You will get result. In the name of Jesus. Shout, waiting pays. It pays to wait. Shout, it pays to wait. Amen. Shale Bragado. You see, I came across a mystery I was asking myself a question, what really happened? I was looking at the life of Noah. Noah waited for 120 how many years? 20 years. And I already explained that mystery to you already. How that 120 came about. So he built an ark, people say 100, but the Bible says it very clearly, is 120 years he waited, building the ark. I already explained to you what it means. However, where I'm going is that at the end of the day, I came to see something about Noah. God said it was done with mankind, that mankind had caused problem, that every motive of your heart is full of evil continually. So God concluded in the ambience of glory, in the waters of eternity, that the end of humanity has come. Because God could do that and create a new one. He can make a life, he can kill. He could destroy the whole world and start all over fresh. Start over fresh, sorry. Start afresh. He could do that. life you choose to do that. But the Bible says, after he has said that to deal with human beings, the Bible says, and Noah found grace. So, in the midst of destruction, somebody was exempted. And I asked myself a question. Why? What was the secret behind his exemption? I prophesy for you. The days of trouble, the days of pandemonium, the days of pandemic, the days of trouble, be with them. You shall be exempted. You shall be exempted. You shall be exempted. The days of coronavirus, you are exempted. You are exempted. You are exempted. That destruction can be promised to come. But some people can be exempted. Noah, how is that? Noah found grace. You will find grace. You will find grace. You will find grace. You will find grace. But my question is, what was his secret? Why did he find grace in the midst of other humanity who were to be destroyed? Why? Oh, friends, I came across what surprised me. That after the flood was over, Noah came up. The first thing he did was to build an altar. And I said, okay, this must be the secret behind this man's success. Why everybody died and he was preserved? Noah became a preserver of the earth. Preserved creation. Because Noah was the salt of the earth. The man that preserved the creation from total annihilation, total destruction. One man preserved the seed of God upon the earth. I was wondering what was the secret behind this. That everybody else died except Noah and his family. What was it? Was it that there was no grace in his time, but he found grace in his time? What was the secret? After the flood, and I saw and Noah built an altar, and God smelled it. Hey, something must be special about this man. And I knew that Noah was a man of the altar. People that wait are people of the altars. People who are waiters are prayer men, are intercessors, altar men, who found solace at the altar, whose consolation is at the altar. When God smells, say, never again will light destroy the earth with flood. Why? A man, a preserver, who knew how to preserve the earth, preserved it, and God said, no more. Friends, no one preserved the earth from another destruction. One man, Kalabaya. Hey, Jesus. I said, one man made God to swear that he will never destroy the earth again. In fact, he had to give man a sign called rainbow to prove to him, I am promising you, because you are a waiter, you are a waiter, you are a prayer man, an intercessor, I'm promising you, by this sign in heaven, the rainbow, the colors of the sky, that I will not bring flood again to destroy the earth. Because the preserver was in the same, preserving the earth and the seed of God. Friends, may God make you a preserver. May God make you a salt of the earth. That any territory you go to, you become salt of that territory. Ah! Kala brakado shababaya. Malu brakada shakabayaba. The Bible says, when they lose their suffer, when someone loses his suffer. Halle mama mama mama. Jesus Christ. There are three things about salt that I found out. What it preserves. Salt is a preserver. Kalibrakado. Before fish was invented, people rubbed salt on animals, on whatever, to preserve longer. Salt was a preservative. So if you're a salt, that means you're a preserver. And a preserver is a prayer warrior. It's a prayer person. It's an intercessor. It's a waiter who waits for the Lord until something happens. He said, I will wait for this period of time. Once there is change. So a waiter waits until change comes. That's the waiter. A waiter does not take it as an answer. A waiter waits despite the no. I won't take it as an answer until I see a change. God told Moses, I know I've promised certain things. He forgot what he had said already. He brought them out of Egypt. And God said, do you want to destroy the people? You brought them from Egypt? You mounted your wings, came out of Egypt, went to kill them in the wilderness? And I would say, God repented. what he wanted to do. One man preserving people, preserving nation. His name was Moses. Because he was a waiter, a prayer man. Friends, it's good to study the Bible. It's to read a manner of things. But if you fail to pray, you are losing the salt. But two property of a salt is able to carry a savour. A savour has to do with seasoning. The men of prayer have a way of creating seasons. Allah brakadosh. That once woman's season is over, you don't have to create a new one. Seasons. Because salt is a seasoner. So a salt can create seasons upon seasons. The technology behind it is that you have this ability to pray, to wait until a season is changed to another. When you lose your saltiness, that means you are lost to salt. You don't have the ability to change seasons. When one season is bad, you have the power, the prowess to change it for good in prayer, in the place of waiting. Am I communicating?
Yes,
sir. So a waiter is a seasoner. Number three, a waiter adds flavor. Mm-hmm. Brings flavor to the earth. A waiter preserves the earth, a waiter brings season to the earth, a waiter brings flavor to the earth. These are three major parts of a salt. Maybe the other ones, but these are major ones I want to share with us. And based upon these properties of the salt, a man who waits can deliver this result upon the earth. Got flavor where there is no flavor, can bring season where there is no season, can bring preservation where there is no preservation to the process of waiting. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Shali Bragadush. So, can you sing that song for me, please, real quickly? Ah. Oh, Yahweh, holy fire. Burn upon my altar. Shali Bragadush. I feel like singing that song. Subra, are you ready to sing that song? Holy fire, burn upon my altar. From within spirits, you take over. Shule Bragado Shababaya. Zebra Gabo Seketele Bragado Sabaya.
Holy fire. Holy fire.
Shabrakado Shakado.
Holy fire.
Just worship him with this song.
Born upon my
own.
Fire, burn upon my altar.
Amen. Psalm 69 verse 3. Read for me, please, quickly.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Psalm 69 verse 3. And I am worn out calling for help.
Listen very carefully. I'm worn out calling for help.
My throat is parched.
Okay.
My eyes fail. Looking for my God.
See that? I am worn out. Everything about me is losing cause. Psalm 69 verse 3. Everything about me losing cause. Everything about me. Friends, we come to a point where we begin to get into certain issues of life, where we become weary. I will show some very quickly. Become weary of life. How will such a man keep going? Such a man need to come to a place of waiting. Begin to get weary. But let me show something quickly. Before I get to that, I'm going to come back to that scripture and back it up. You see, let me quickly say this. People think that when you are waiting, it means that it means an inaction. No. When you are waiting, the core of waiting, let me read this up, please. The core of waiting is one. You wait in prayer. The core of waiting on the Lord, one, you wait in prayer. Two, you wait in fasting. Three, you wait in the word of God. Four, you wait in listening to God. Five, you wait in patience. So when you are fast, when you are waiting, does not mean inaction. You won't do nothing. You won't go to work. No. Even as in the midst of all this, you have this hour around you, the dimension around you that you are waiting. You are focused. You wait in the word. You study God's word more than ever before. You pray more than ever before. You fast more than ever before. You listen to God more than ever before. And with patience, endurance. Amen?
Amen.
I'll run through this very quickly. The values of waiting. One, changes come. Because of time, I will not go into, because I want to go to, I can go to where I want, what I want to say. The values of waiting, number one, changes come. Psalm 123 verse 2. Read that place quickly. 123 verse 2.
Praise
Hallelujah.
The Lord. Hallelujah. Psalm 123 verse 2.
Mm-hmm.
As the eyes of the slave look to the hand of their master,
mm-hmm.
as the eyes of a maid look to the hand of her mistress,
mm-hmm.
so our eyes look to the Lord our God till he shows us his mercy.
So that till he shows us his mercy. So when you wait on the Lord, you receive changes. It is there that he shows you his mercy. That's waiting. Wait in prayer, wait in word of God, wait in fasting, wait in listening to God, wait in endurance, in patience. Amen?
Amen.
So with that, he waits there until he shows you his word, mercy. So that means change must come. Your change must come.
Amen.
Number two, you receive rest. In waiting, one of the value again, number two value is rest. Waiting, you calm yourself down. Say, hey, I'm going too fast. It's time to slow down. Amen?
Amen.
Psalm 23 verse 2. 3 verse 2, 23 verse 2. 23 verse 2.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. For he found 23. He makes me lie down in green pastures.
Mm-hmm.
He leads me beside quiet waters.
Leads me beside still waters. Waters that are still. Amen. God does not take a waiter through the troubled waters. He brings it to his still waters. So he can be calm, collected, and focused. Number three, God at the place of waiting, God fights. In other words, you are handing over the fight to the hand of God. When you're waiting, God has taken over the fight. It's no more you fighting, it's God fighting. Amen. You can see that in Exodus 14:14. Very quickly, I'm rushing to, I can go to what I want to say.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Exodus 14 verse 14, I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still.
See that? So when a man is waiting, he's still. When a man is still, somebody fights, not you. Because you can't tell me to be waiting, and then I have hands to fight. I have my leg, but yeah, I'm just waiting. My hands are folded. That means I will stay, and then you come and deal with me. Come and... Yeah, I'm communicating. My hands are folded. My legs are cramped. I cannot do anything. Say I should wait. Okay, I'm waiting. Then what happens? Supposing the enemy come and hit me. No. It's the first case that when you're waiting, you're telling God, take over. My hands are tight. I can't do anything. My legs, you say I should sit down, I should wait. Okay, I'm waiting. Then who fights for me? God fights for you. Amen. If God tells you something, he takes responsibility. Doesn't leave you there. He said, I will not leave you, nor forsake you. So without my waiting, he fights. He takes away your fight. So we can see that they say, be still, I will fight. Number four, it sharpens your confidence and sensitivity in the spirit. 1 John 5:14. 1 John, the book of John.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 1 John 5:14, and I read in Jesus' name. Mm-hmm. Amen. This is the confidence we have in approaching God, mm-hmm. that if we ask anything according to his will, he mm-hmm. hears us.
So that this, we develop confidence while waiting. Confidence. Our spirit is sharpened more. Number five, it purifies and gives you endurance. Okay, read God's word tries you. Okay, read Psalm 105, verse 19. Verse 19.
I read it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Psalm 105, verse 19. Till what he foretold came to pass, till the word of the Lord proved him true.
Can another version? Hallelujah.
Till what he has predicted came true, the word of the Lord proved him right.
Okay, the Bible says, until God's word come, God's word, the same God's word tried it. Am I communicating? Until God, that thing God told you, right? I'll do this. That word will also try you first.
Yes.
You see, it's a mystery. God told you I will give you patience, but it brings impatience to give you patience. It's the word of the Lord. That's the way he does his whole thing. Oh, I will give you patience, don't worry. Oh, Lord, give me patience. Oh, Lord, give me patience. He'll not give you impatience. To try your patience. I don't understand. Now God works. Amen. Oh Lord, make me a healer. And then you begin to feel some pain. I'm asking for healing. You are giving me. What kind of thing is this? Okay, what to be a healer? Okay, feel the way healer. People who are pain, feel it. Go through it first of all. Amen. Praise God. Like say you want to die, you want to taste death. You should taste death. Know how people that die. Jesus Christ will taste death. God, man have to taste death. So he has to taste death. So know how we taste death. So everything God tells you, will try you with it first. When you pass, you become a champion. So when God, oh, I will do this for you. Paul say war. Say war. That prophecy you have received, war. I told you about prophecy. Oh la la. No. Obey the instruction. Fight. If you don't do that, this prophecy will come and just go. You know, I say, man of God, prophesy. No, it doesn't work that way. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So, until God's word came, God's word will try you. He will. He will. You want to be an Elijah? Kalabagosh. You will first of all taste wilderness, locusts, and honey. So that the spirit of Elijah will come upon you in the wilderness. If we can come out. That was John Baptist. He came upon him. He has to be in wilderness first of all. Eat locusts and honey to engage the spirit of God. It's not easy to break through and call in the spirit of the Lord upon your life. Amen? But God made to go through that to collect his spirit by the power and the spirit of Elijah upon his life. Six, the kingdom-mindedness, Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. While you're doing that, God focuses you and make you kingdom-minded. Seek for the kingdom. I have seven of them. Before I go to what I want to say. Matthew 6, 33, seek for the kingdom. The popular kingdom, I'll eventually be added. So, you're looking for something to be added to you, or that other things you believe God for, then seek his kingdom first. You can only seek him first. Seek him when you can prepare an environment to wait. Amen? Wait. Seven, you develop fellowship and intimacy with the Spirit of the Lord. Acts chapter 1, verse 8. Can you read that quickly? Why wait till you develop intimacy? Intimacy, fellowship with the Spirit of the Lord. The book of Acts 1:8, yeah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Acts 1:8. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you'll be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth.
Read the one before them. What verse is that? That's the next.
He said to me, it's not for you to know the times or day the Father has set by his own authority.
Verse 7.
Is it verse 7? Okay, verse 7. Okay. He said, wait till you're dressed up until you do power. That should be in there. That should be look. Okay. Sorry about that. Okay. Anyway, it's still something.
It's verse 4.
Verse 4. Okay. Good.
On the occasion while he was eating with them, he gave them this command. Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you've heard me speak about.
That's verse 4, right?
Yes.
Sorry about that. Verse 4. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. So he said, wait until power comes. You see, there's a beauty in waiting. They have to wait for 9 days after the ascension of Jesus to receive the power. Supposedly they have gone and said, Peter said, oh la la, let's. In fact, they went. Until Christ met them again. In fact, they went fishing already. Peter went back to struggles. The same struggle the master met him in. He went back to struggle. He couldn't wait until Jesus came and said, you know what? Wait till. Fish again. Don't go fishing. Don't go fishing again. It's enough. Wait. You have struggled too long. Too far. Now you have to wait. When you don't wait, you struggle. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
Lack of waiting makes the man to struggle. Mm-hmm. So when he waited and they were singing psalms, praising God, they were no part of singing psalms, praising God, do more of things, and Holy Ghost of a sudden, power came. Friends, when you wait, change comes.
Yeah.
Amen. I just want to establish this foundation before. Now, can I go deeper to go higher?
Yes, sir.
Kala bragado shabaya. Sule bragado. I'll give us, by the grace of God, about 2 or 3 points so we can close. Shale bragado shababa. Let's go to a book of Isaiah, chapter 4, a popular scripture. You know, when you mention waiting, that's where people's mind go to first. Right? Okay. Isaiah chapter 40. Isaiah 40, chapter, let's read from 25 to 31.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. To whom will you compare me?
Listen very carefully. Go ahead.
Or who is my equal, says the Holy One.
Mm-hmm.
Lift your eyes and look to the heavens, who created all these. He who brings out the starry hosts one by one and calls them each by name. Because of his great power and mighty strength, not one of them is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and complain, O Israel? My way is hidden from the Lord. My course is disregarded by my God. Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God.
Yes.
The creator of the heaven, of the ends of the earth.
Mm.
He will not grow weary. He will not grow tired or weary.
Mm.
And his understanding no one can fathom.
Mm.
He gives strength to the weary
and
increases the power of the weak.
Mm.
Even youths grow tired and weary and young men stumble and fall.
Mm.
But those who wait, who hope in the Lord, will renew their strength.
Hallelujah.
They will soar on wings like eagles.
Mm.
They will run and not grow weary.
Mm.
They will walk and not be faint.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This God is powerful. First of all, gave himself. He introduced himself to you to tell you who he is. He does not grow weary.
Ndine chere Jehovah. Hage fe are di gugo Haga bo so gai je Ika gai awoa.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Friends, at this point in time, Israelites have suffered the hands of Assyrians. They've suffered, just to make it very quickly, they've suffered and now they are tired. Worn out. They are tired. They've lost hope. So, if you are very familiar with the book of Isaiah, from 40 to about 48, it began to bring hope to them again. Yes, we have seen that you've been through all this, but the Lord is coming to give you hope, to give you rest. That's why he said, you see, verse 1, he said, comfort ye my people, comfort ye my people. You see, comfort has already coming. I decree, after this meeting today, everywhere and anyhow you have been discomforted, Holy Ghost will comfort you. The comforter will visit you. He will visit you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, precious Father. So at this point in time, God began to introduce himself again to them. Let them know that it's a God who can bring strength to the weak. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
A God can bring restoration to those who have lost hope. It's an introduction of, began to tell him, look, have you forgotten that he gave power to the faint, to them that have no might? He increases strength. He said, even the youth shall faint. He said, even you, say, in other words, youth who have strength, no youth, by virtue of their physical strength, they can produce anyway. No, he said, even youth who are very strong and comparison to the old ones, who can run anywhere. And, you know, he said, even the youth, they shall faint with their strength. And be weary. He said, the young men shall also totally fail. Young with all their youthful experiences, they will still fail. That's not said, despite all this, he said, but they that wait. So in the midst of your youthful experiences, youthful strength, in the midst of your young, whatever you are doing, he said, you will still fail, faint too. He said, but those who wait, hallelujah, upon the Lord shall renew their strength, and they shall mount up with wings as eagles, they shall run. Now, there are four things I have to bring out here. Number one, he said, those that wait upon the Lord, that's the subject matter, they will renew their strength, one. Two, they shall mount up with wings as eagles. Three, they shall run and be not weary. Please mark this word, I want to say something about them. And four, they shall walk and not faint. So there are three things I want to note in this verse 31. And the subject is only for they who wait. Bible says, they that wait. Which means there are some people who don't wait. There are some who don't have the culture of waiting. There are some who cannot fast, who cannot pray. There are some who cannot even pray. They pray 10 minutes highest, they are gone. You are missing waiting. The mystery of waiting will not encounter you. It will be a waiter. Just like a waiter waits for you in a restaurant. You see, the smile of a waiter is to take a pen and a note and say, what do you need, ma? What do you need, sir? Wait for your instruction. Am I communicating? He's just waiting patiently for your instruction. And then until you are done, she will not leave. Okay, I want to order chicken a la carte. I want to order isiewu. I want to order... I want to order egusi soup. So, the waiter waits patiently until you are done ordering. He now leaves to bring the order. That's the example of a waiter. He will not leave an inch from you while you're ordering. Have you ever seen a waiter leaving you in the midst of your ordering? No, it's called a waiter, a waitress. You have to wait until your instruction is fully passed. The same way, we are supposed to wait until the master is done with us. Until we see changes, until we see his mercy, until we see results. The same way, just picturize a waiter in a restaurant that he cannot, by any reason, leave you in the middle of your order. The same way, God will not want to leave in the middle of his instructions. Am I communicating? He says that the youth, full of exuberances, full of youthful power and prowess, he says, even with that kind of strength, they will still fail. Even with that kind of strength, they will fall, they will fail, they will grow weary. But he said, they that wait. Ladies and gentlemen, I discovered two things. Indeed, let me just start with that. That in the world as a whole, that we are running too much, we are walking too fast. Am I communicating? And we are walking too fast, going away. God is saying, with all your strengths, whatever you are doing as a youthful person, that you will not go far. You can't attempt to go far until you learn to be a waiter. Wait on me, because your strength will fail you. Your physical strength will fail you. And for those who are already born again, even your strength, spiritual strength, will fail if you don't wait from time to time. He said, don't be too much there. Just wait. Okay, let me just take one more to avoid. Now, number one, he said, those that wait, number one, they will have their strength renewed. What it means is what we call exchange. Renewal means an exchange. That when you wait before the Lord, there's an exchange between God. Now, you come to God with your weakness. Picture this very well. You come to God with your weakness. I don't know what I've told you before. You go to pray, you're feeling weak. You're tired and worn out. You have been through work. You have been through this. You have spoken to your children. Just put them to bed. And then now you are now tired. With all your youthful strength, all your strength everywhere, you are now tired. You are going to work. You are back. You helped your husband or helped your wife. And you put your children to bed. Now you want to pray. You are just weak. Weakness has set in. Praise the Lord. Because opposite of weakness is strength. Both of strength is weakness. So at this point, you are weak. You need strength. And you are there in, before God, trying to wait upon Him. And you are tired. Some of you will be yawning. Some of you yawning on the prayer line. Oh. You are weak. Weakness has set in. Amen. Every second you are yawning. Some weakness in your system. You are just weak. Amen. The same with friends, as we feel weak physically. At the point comes, you feel weak spiritually. That's what you're believing God for, trusting God for. It's not coming, you're not discouraged. You are troubled every side. You are weak. You are believing God for something for many years. It has not come. Now you're getting packed up, getting troubled. You're getting anxious. You are weak. At this point, you need an exchange. So God said, at this point, when you have used up your spiritual strength, you have prayed and prayed. Now you are weak, you can't even pray. You have done this and done that. You can't go further than 10 minutes. You're just weak. You can't go further than 10 minutes. You can't further than 30 minutes. Yes, you want to pray for 1 hour, 2 hours, you can't even go further. You are weak. Now, as if I want to you, but you just need to pray, God, help me. Help me, Lord. I am tired. I can't even pray. I feel you're again. You're tired. You go to your bed, you put your head this way. You're tired. You woke up again. In fact, some people even do like this for the when you're tired, it's not that you don't take that posture, please. When you're physically tired and exhausted, which is nature, you know, you're tired and exhausted. Don't go to your bed and do like this. If only you do, that's it, you are gone. For me, whatever time you are praying to morning, she say yeah. Praise the Lord. Don't do that. I'm telling the truth. You're gonna find yourself sleeping. And then the worst of all is that while you're doing that, they come and give you food. Take some food. That's even the worst. They give you food. Or someone come and take a cane and then on your head. Shall God forbid. Or even the one that even bother me is that, you know, you are weak. Then why are you saying contemplative prayers like rosary? You're already weak. One day, and let me know because I don't want people to take care of me. Then one day I was with a man of God. I don't mention whatever. Man of God. You know. We just finished vigil and we're in the bus going home. It would take us about 1 hour there about. He came with us for the program. While we're leaving, he put out his rosary. He's a man of God. I don't want to mention, so that I will not be. He said, while we are there, people are sleeping. He brought the rosary. I told myself, watch you. You're going to sleep now. Back in. Follow it. Rosary starts saying him. Stop him saying rosary. So, at this point, I said, why don't just keep this thing now? Don't say contemplative prayer when you are weak. Say vibrant, loud prayer. Say an exercising prayer. I was pace around, pace, move. Amen? He said, because I will exchange my strength to weakness. You have to give God the opportunity to exchange it. You can't go and put your head in the bed and say rosary. You are not giving God the opportunity to exchange it. You are blocking the exchange. Because you are weak. Why not exercise yourself, pace around, strengthen yourself, do it if possible, can you even do exercise while praying, until the strength is being exchanged. The weakness is changed with strength. A point comes when we need to pray, oh God help me, oh Lord strengthen me. A point comes That's the moment of the spirit that God arrives in your system and usurps your weakness and gives you strength. That's the moment it comes. That's the moment. As you are praying, that's why even me, by grace of God, I pray to pray. I don't know what I'm saying. Because I pray a certain hour at night, midnight, no, night, when no people are sleeping. So I have to pray to pray. Then I will have to ask for strength. I do my first in what I call initial prayer, preparatory prayer. Oh Lord, I'm come before you to help me to pray. Give me strength to pray. Give me strength to pray. I am weak. I'm born to walk. I'm tired. In fact, I'm just eating my body. I feel like sleeping. Strengthen me, Lord. Oh Lord, strengthen me, Lord. I feel tired. Help me, Lord. What I'm saying, oh God, help me. I'm doing like this, I'm bending. Sometimes I sit down. Ah, say, man, be careful. Shut up. Oh Lord, help me. I'm preparing myself to do the real prayer. Praise God. Friends, but I guess all of a sudden, I've seen you walk over and over again. All of a sudden, I just feel this sudden surge of power. That is what we're talking about. As we wait on Him, that's exchange. He gives you His strength and takes your weakness. And you cannot be to fire. Friends, for that point, you can fire for 1 hour, 2 hours, and 3 hours. You're not tired. Because the strength of God has come in. You begin to see yourself praying and praying. You're not tired. That means God's strength is there now. Pray. Am I communicating? That exchange of strength. When divinity now kisses the humanity, you see a surge of strength in you. Am I communicating? Number two, people who have been through life affairs, troubles of life, bewildered, anxiety, news from Nigeria, news from one of the African places, news even in America, news anywhere, wherever. Bad news, corona, everywhere full of news, full of bad news. You have heard and heard, and your body is now weak. Your spirit man is tired and weak. Friends, at such a time, you need the strength of God because you are weak. Strength. I need to pray, God, give me your strength. Give me your strength. You need to wait to get such a strength. Sometimes you demand to fast and to pray, do extraordinary prayer to get that strength. You can't be going through such a weakness and troubles, family trouble, maybe you go through divorce, whatever you're going through, and you just pray 10 minutes prayer. No, you can't have an exchange for that. I'm not really getting 10 minutes prayer. I mean, it works. Praise the Lord. I'm saying that you want to wait on the Lord for something higher, something bigger. You need to go extra mile. I told even the Shaman says it very well. Say you're going to wait, stay there, don't go anywhere until something happens. Right? That's waiting. So, okay, troubles everywhere, new partners everywhere. Body, you are so weak, no strength. You feel dejected, rejected, everybody is telling you bad news everywhere. Okay, at this point you are weak. What do you do? You need God's strength. What do? You begin to wait. Wait until something happens. Until the strength of God comes into your system. Wait. Then when it comes, you fire. Am I going to get it?
Yes, sir.
Three. You might be a spiritual giant. Praying and fasting, praying and fasting, praying and fasting. Pray and fasting. At the point, you need to feel some weakness. Bible says here that if you are in the spirit, if you live in the spirit, also walk in the spirit. Am I going to get it? At the point, you might even be feeling spiritually weak in your body, in your system. Everything about you, you are praying and praying and fasting, and you are feeling discouraged. Friends, you need to wait on the Lord to get your strength. Your weakness is your strength of God. Am I going to get it? Number two, it says here that they shall mount up with wings as eagles. Now, to give a very good picture of this place, read Exodus 19:14 for me quickly. Exodus 19:14, and to be fast. Exodus 19:14. Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Exodus 19:14.
Mm-hmm.
And after Moses had gone down the mountain to the people,
mm-hmm.
he consecrated them. And they washed their clothes.
Is that 19?
Yes, Exodus 19:14.
19:14.
Yes.
Mm.
He said to the people, prepare yourselves for the third day. Abstain. Oh.
Is that you sure? Is that 19? Exodus 19:14?
Yeah, Exodus 19:14 said, after Moses had gone down the mountain.
Don't worry about it. Anyway, I'm referring to the place where he said, I bore you as an eagle. Who bore his eaglets. I brought you out of Egypt the same way. So you see, when you talk about eaglet, eagle's wing, you are talking about freedom, strength, power. You see, look at the majestic presence of eagle.
It's on verse 4.
Verse 4.
Yes.
Is it 4? Okay, you go.
You yourselves have seen what I did to Egypt,
okay,
and how I carried you on eagle's wing,
okay,
and brought you to myself.
Okay, good. 14. Sorry about that again. That's the second time I'm making this. So it's showing us the way, what eagle, what it means to appear on eagle's wing. He said, I've carried you. Now, if you see an eagle who wants to train his eaglets, he can take the eaglets far above the altitude, and when he gets there, it leaves the eaglet to start going down. Because he wants to train the eaglet how to soar. But guess what? The eagle will not let the eaglet land on the rock. Before it will land, boom, it comes and spread its wings and take it off again. Exactly what God does to us. I will not leave you nor forsake you. Boom, he carries you again. It looks as if we are wearied. We are going through troubles of life. Nobody is helping you. There's no help anywhere. Your husband is not helping, your wife is not helping, your children are not helping. These are just going this way. You look as if like an eaglet who has left its eaglet to just fall. As you are about to land, it comes again. Boom. And takes you up again. So now what God means by those who wait will be the same, to be like the same thing, the same picture I just showed you now. Like an eagle who just comes to take its eaglet and go up again. So if you're a child of God, you're under the loss. Only those that wait will encounter such move of God. Those that wait. That he will not leave you. So we are going through troubles of life. Wait on him. So he can give you a picture, an experience of an eagle with an eaglet. The only place you can experience eagle with an eaglet is in a place of waiting. When you are going through troubles, it's as if you are about to crash. He just comes and picks you up again and take you higher again. We will now say, what a mighty God. I serve because that you are taking you up again. Yes, at the point again, you will now leave again. Oh, where have you left me? You don't want to die. Where are you? Go, where are you? You are about to fall. But guess what? He will leave you to land. He will come again and pick you up. So take it. Picks the legs. He will leave you to land. Friends, you will not crash land. I say you won't crash land. You will not crash land. Before it looks as if you are crashing, the eagle will come and pick you up again with his wings. So you are mounting up with wings as eagle. You are mounting up on the eagle's wing. So Bible says mounting up, which means God will come and pick you back again to what he has told you. What has God told you? As he told you, you are the head, not the tail. When it looks as if you are becoming the tail, he comes with his wings to take you up again to become the head. Looks as if he said you are a success, not a failure. When it looks as if you are failing, he comes again with his wings and take you up to be a success. God will never leave you nor forsake you. Everything he has told you, he will fulfill it. He will fulfill it. He will do it. He will do it. He will do it. In the name of Jesus, he will mount you on wings. He said, I carried you as an eagle carries an eaglet. I carried you out of Egypt. The same way, friends, God keeps carrying you and I as an eagle carries its eaglet up. Am I communicating? In the days of trouble, he will carry you. Days of problem, he will carry you. Days of difficulties, he will carry you. He will let you crash land. But we serve the true and living God, who is the same yesterday, the same today, the same forevermore. If God has done it using eagle's picture, it's your turn. I say it's your turn. I say it's your turn. You will not crash land. You will not crash land. You will not crash land. The eagle will pick you up. Ah, Holy Ghost, our ego. Yeah, brakato shababa. Holy Ghost, our ego. He will pick you up on his wings and take you higher and higher. Shut, I'm going higher. Shut, I'm going higher. He will take you higher. Holy Ghost will take you higher. Friends, at the place of waiting, Holy Ghost takes you higher. He takes you higher and higher. He takes you higher and higher. What you are trusting God for? Is it a gift? Is it a charisma? Holy Ghost picks you up in the place of waiting and gives you charisma and gives you power and gives you anointing. Ah, they that wait upon the Lord. The second thing is that you mount up with wings as eagles. Number three, Bible says that they shall run and not be weary. Jesus. You see, that's what God made people to sleep. Friends, it does not like sleep man will die out of exhaustion. Because we are too much running here and there, let us scatter. Too much trouble everywhere, physically. Now, let me give you a picture of this. You see, the picture of God was trying to paint here, like when you say somebody is weary, the person is tired out of pressure and exhaustion. That's weary. When somebody is weary, when somebody is said to be weary, is tired out of pressure or exhaustion. That's why God gave us a picture of a widow and a judge. He said, lest she weary me. In other words, lest she pressure me and I get tired and fucked out. So God used that picture of weary to tell us that in our day-to-day life, even physically, we run into things. We are running too much. That we feel exhausted at the end of the day. We feel tired, we can't pray. Am I communicating? We feel worn out, we are tired, we want to go to bed. We want to hit the bed. So the picture gives us that if you run around with all your strength as a youth, you run around, you're going to get tired. You're going to get weary. But if you can pick up time and a period to wait on the Lord, you will take that exhaustion, that tiredness. He said, they that run will not be weary. Which means we give you the anointing, a superfluous anointing. Anointing beyond measure. So that the weariness will not be your portion. I declare you won't be weary. You won't be weary. Even the realm of the spirit, when we run around with spiritual things, run around. No, you know, some people, let me even say this very clearly. Some people are too full of activities. When I say that means that there has no spiritual connotation, like, you know, they're here, then this party. Sorry, I mentioned party again, I'm sorry. Just give a picture. Then this party, that party, then this meeting, that meeting, travel meeting, this one meeting. Everywhere they're just running. Am I communicating? No time to wait. That's what God said, they that wait. It means there are people that run that way, run, without waiting. So, praise God. You run everywhere. No spiritual waiting, nothing, no fasting, no prayer. So, but they that choose to not exclude themselves, go and wait at the period of time. You say, they the one that even though you have run around, you are tired, when you come, God will exchange your strengths and you won't be weary anymore. Am I communicating? Spiritually again, some of us must have been doing so much, even those of us who are preachers, we run with the scripture, we preach, we pray, all manner of things that we do. Sometimes we run and run to preaching, to prayer. You know, if you don't find time to wait, even as a preacher, you're going to get weary. Any ministry, it could be singing, it could be whatever, it could be teacher. You don't find time to wait, you're going to get weary. And I've told you elements of waiting. You wait in prayer, wait in the word, waiting. So all those elements, you have to put them to say, Father, I've been preaching for so time, I've been doing this for so time, I've been teaching so time, I want to now wait. I want to wait on you. Give me strength. Teach me new things. Give me, you see, that's that because of lack of waiting, some preachers lack adequate revelation. Could they give up all they have, they become weary. As if the preacher get nothing new, could they preach and preach every day exhausted? Praise God. But if you see preachers who have something new to offer you every time, that means they always wait to receive freshness, fresh revelation. Am I communicating?
Yes,
so if you don't wait, you're going to round up yourself and you begin to get still. That's why some preachers, before knowing, they're out of stage. They can't preach anymore. They are now weary. Too much preaching has wearied them. For one of the preachers, I just said, when God called him, one of the problems he had was, what will you preach throughout his lifetime? That's his problem. What do I preach? How do I preach it? Amen? But because he has been in the ministry for about maybe 50 years now, he's still preaching. New things, fresh things for him. So, because preachers need to find time to wait. That's also that you don't hear the voice of preachers on the line, or the word of preachers or whatever in the church, but they want to go and wait to get something fresh to give out. Because it's not easy. Keep giving. You need to wait. So freshness, power, anointing come as a result of waiting. Even those in power ministry, you went to prayer ministry, you went to power, manifestation, Holy Ghost ministration. You miss out today, you are tired. When you call you again, you just raise and nothing is going on. Why? Because you have not waited. Waiting has a way of bringing, exchanging divinity with humanity. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
Shall they that wait?
They that wait.
Shall they that wait?
They that
ways. Amen. Now, look at the last one he says. And they shall walk and not faint. Now, this is different from running. Running, you've been going here and there, too much going. Now, there are some people who actually walk. Walk like a millipede. Amen. No run, like too much running like that. You're not taking that. But yet, even if they say they need waiting. Amen. They also need waiting. I would say if you live in the spirit, also walk in. If you live, you also walk in the spirit. So even those who walk in the spirit, they need waiting at a point in time. Because if you don't wait, even the one you know, you faint. What's not fainting? Fainting simply means when you are tired, weak and dizzy. Say that out loud. You are weak and dizzy as a result of lack of supply of oxygen. That's how the channel defines it. You are now weak. Now, weakness comes here now because you're not walking. We are weak and dizzy, losing consciousness as a result of lack of supply of oxygen to your brain. Amen. The same thing happens in the spirit. You walk and walk and walk and walk. We are fainting because you have not found time to wait on the Lord. No supply of power, no supply of anointing, no supply of the word of God. Because you're not studying the word, you are not praying where you should. You're just walking, walking, walking. No supply. Bible said this, that those that wait on him, they will not faint because of the supply. I pray for you. May God supply your anointing. 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 In the name of Jesus. May God supply you anointing. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Sorry, I have to teach today. I just want to teach this into you can understand if that's what I'm going through. Not so. Amen. Okay, let's do this. Can someone read for me? Let me read that to close. Read this one close. So, Songs of Solomon 1:16. Songs of Solomon 1:16. Shale Bragadosha. Have I communicated what it means to wait?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Have I? Praise God. Amen. Amen. So, because we're about to go to waiting, let us look at waiting, because waiting is one of the mysteries that these men carried that made them to become who they became. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Songs of Solomon 1:6. Chapter 1, verse 6.
Look not upon me,
mm-hmm.
because I am swearing.
Sweating? What is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Look upon me because I'm sweating.
Mm-hmm.
Because the sun has scorned me. My mother's son were incensed against me. Mm. They make me keeper of the vineyard.
Shale Bragado Shalom.
But my own vineyard I have not kept.
Praise the Lord. Can I have another question about that? Another question?
Do not stare at me because I am darkened by the sun. My mother's son were angry with me and made me take care of the vineyards. My own vineyard I had to make alone.
Look not upon me because I'm black. Because the sun had looked upon me. Ayagabush. Sakatalam Ragadish. Ladies and gentlemen. What is Songs of Solomon trying to say here? That when you are at the outer courts of God, the sun looks upon you and darkens you. The sun changes your color into darkness. He's not saying the sun is bad. No, what I'm to tell you, when you are outside, there's a tendency of running too much, walking too much. There's a tendency of not waiting because you're always in a hurry outside. Hurry, 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 hurry. So you don't wait when you're outside. So the sun darkens you. So your spirit is darkened. Your body is darkened. Your life is darkened. Because there's no waiting. But when you move to the inner court, I begin to hold the horns of the inner chamber. Where the sun will not directly hit you. But the sun of righteousness is the inner chamber. Outside the court. The physical sun hits you and make you black. Turn your life around into blackness and darkness. Until you can enter to the holy courts where you can hold the horns of prayer. The horns of waiting that the sun, which is Son of God, begin to shine upon you. Am I communicating? So your life can receive an exchange. Friends, inside the inner court is the Son of God, the Son of Righteousness, the Holy Ghost, the power of God, the menorah, kalabaya. Inside the inner court is the menorah, the light of God, the Son of God, the power of God inside. Outside the sun, the physical sun, to darken you. Friends, running too much and walking too much will darken you. You need to find a way to the inner circle of God, where the menorah is, kalabaya, to see the light of God, so that your life will brighten. Outside you are darkened, inside you are brightened. Am I communicating? Outside under the physical sun, you are darkened. He said, the sun has looked upon me. Who is looking upon you? Is it God or the physical sun? Is it the menorah, the light of God looking upon you, or the outside sun? Which sun looking at you? Is it the sun of the heavens or the sun of righteousness looking upon you? He said, if the outer one look upon you, he said, my path become dark. Darkness will become your portion. Because the sun out there, too much running, too much walking, too much this, too much that. No time to wait. But those who wait are the ones that are gravitating to the inner court. Where there is menorah, where the light of God is, the Son of Righteousness is, where you can encounter the light of God. Am I communicating? Aye, Baba. Friends, when you get to such a place, when you wait upon the Lord, anything can happen. Shakatali brekete, makotoli brakada. Anything can happen. Je brakato sakata. My battle close. Get to pray. Masokotoli Baba. Aye, Baba. So the sun has looked down upon me. Looked upon me. I'm dark. Makotoba. Outer court, sun looks down upon you, and you are dark. Inner court, the Son of Righteousness looks upon you, and you are brightened. What do you want? You want to be in inner chamber or outside chamber? What are you looking for? Those who wait upon the Lord are brightened. The menorah smiles upon them. Menorah brightens their life, brightens their path. Friends, too much running, too much walking under the sun can darken your soul, can darken your spirit. Find yourself to the inner court, where there is light of God. Find yourself there. Malo brakata shekete, mali brakata ze brokoto, e shakata li brekete, makababa, makoto. I am tired of being on the sun. I want to be in a court. Ladies and gentlemen, that's why Bible says Romans chapter 8 verse 19 that the creation is waiting for the manifestation. Even the creation is waiting for you, for your waiting. Creation is waiting for your waiting. Jump on your feet. The creation is waiting for your waiting. Shakata babaya. You see, you cannot manifest God until you wait. You cannot manifest God until you wait. And the creation is waiting for you to wait. And until you wait, there's no manifestation. You got to move from the outer court to inner court where there's light of God. Outside there, the sun will darken you. The sun will darken your life, darken your soul, darken your spirit. Outside there, too much running, too much walking, too much this, too much that. God is saying it's time to wait. Wait in inner court where the Son of Righteousness will look upon you with brightness. That your soul be brightened, that your spirit be brightened, that your life be brightened. My God, Lord, take me to the inner court. Shakoto, that's your prayer. Lord, take me to the inner court. I shakata li brekete, mali brakato sakata. Take me to the inner court. Mali brakata. I am tired and weary. I am tired and weary. Aya baba. Outside the inner court, I am tired and weary. I am tired and weary. I feel like giving up. I feel like packing it up. Outside the outer court, I feel like packing it up. Outside the outer court, I am discouraged. Outside the outer court, I feel like giving up. Oh Lord, take me to the inner court. Where there's menorah, where is the light of God, light of righteousness? The Son of Righteousness, we gaze upon me, we gaze upon me, we gaze upon me. We gaze upon me, we gaze upon me, we gaze upon me. Sole brakada lakada, sele brakada lakada, ye brakada lakada, sele brakada lakada, esakada lakada, mayanda lakada lakada, sele brakada lakada lakada, mala brakada lakada, sele brakada lakada lakada, sele brakada lakada lakada, esala brakada lakada lakada, sele brakada lakada lakada, mayanda brakada lakada, ye baba lakada lakada, mayanda lakada. Yeah, brother, yeah, brother, yeah, brother. Oh my God, I think I spent so much time in teaching. But let me show you something. Let me show you a mystery. Listen, let me show you a mystery. You can pray with it. Oh my God, I wish I said that earlier, but that's fine. Now listen to this very carefully. Oh, but everything, every cattle that Abraham had, all the cattle and beauties, all the money he had, friends and gentlemen, do you know, when Abraham was handing over to Isaac, he never gave him any cattle. No cattle, no sheep, no money. He gave him blessing. Friends, when you wait on the Lord, you come out with a potent word. When the Lord gives you potency, when you come out of the prayer room, the place of waiting, you carry potency. I don't need to give you silver nor gold. I don't need to give you car. House.
Amen.
All you need is a blessing, impartation.
Yeah.
Impartation can make you repeat what I have.
Yes,
Karabaya. You can only get that in place of waiting. Abraham waited and he imparted unto Isaac. The same way, friends, Kaliba, Isaac waited. He imparted unto Jacob. Isaac never gave Jacob cattle. Do you know what I'm saying? And then Isaac now gave the legacy of cattle to
Jacob.
No. Am I going to get it?
Yes.
Even when Jacob came to, I'm rushing now, came to bless the people, his 12 sons, he never gave them cattle nor silver. He gave them prophecy.
Amen.
He gave them the word.
Amen.
Friends, people that already gave the word, I speak like power flow. Revelation. All through the time Jesus was with the apostles, they saw his life of prayer. They said, Master, teach us how to pray. They were wondering how this gift will manifest a healing miracle everywhere. What was the secret behind it? The apostles could not perform these things. Why? Because they've not waited. Now say, I'm about to go. Wait in Jerusalem until. Friends, when power came upon them, word of knowledge, prophecy, healing, miracles. Friends, it pays to wait. When you wait on the Lord, power comes to exchange your weakness. Oh God, exchange my weakness with your power. Anoint me in the place of waiting. Anoint me in the place of waiting. I am tired of this life. I can't live a life, a powerless life. I am tired of a powerless life. Witches are comforting me here and there. Strong men are comforting me from village. I can't do anything because there's no power. Oh Lord, as I wait on you, anoint me to handle the powers. Anoint me to handle witches. Anoint me to anoint for power. In the place of waiting. In the place of waiting. We are tired of powerlessness. 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 Lord, anoint me. Let me carry power. Let me carry power. Let me carry power. Let me carry power. Zule Bakada. Mayandolo Bakadoli Gede. Shema Baba Baba Baba. Let me carry power. I am tired of powerless life. Tired of powerless life. I am tired of powerless life. Let me carry power. Let me carry power. Let me carry power. I am tired of powerless life. In the name of Jesus. Friends, upon the strength of this revelation, please don't concentrate on laying up wet for your children. I beg you. Don't be saying, let me do this to give my children. Don't concentrate on that alone because it might fail them. But there's something you can get from the place of the Spirit called waiting. That when you come out, your words will carry potential power. Amen. And you call your child and say, my child, I bless you. I call you blessed. That word you speak will carry them for life.
Amen.
Much, much better than gold and silver. The place of waiting. This is thing that men carried in those days. When the finished wait that come out, power flows. Place of waiting. Kali Brakada. Ayagaba. Am I coming again? Power can flow through your words because you got it from the place of prayer, the place of waiting. Oh God, let me walk in power.
Let me walk in power.
Let me walk in power.
Shabrakato, se brakata, mali brakete, mala brakata, e shakato, mali brakete, e brakato sakato, mali brakete, maya mala brakete, makoto ni brakete, mala brakato sakato, e brakato sakato, maya toloba, e brakato sakato, e brakato sakato, maya dala papa lokoto, e brakato sakato, maya dala papa lokoto, ah papa. I will wait. Seriously? Oh Jesus. Oh Jesus. Oh Jesus. If you need acceleration,
wait.
If you need acceleration, of life wait. Acceleration brings you calm. Waiting brings you acceleration. Waiting brings you speed. Elijah went on a speed on acceleration because he waited. Not in a hurry. I pray for you, lift up your hands. That as you begin to wait for this 3-day drive fast and 7 days for those who are doing 7 days, I pray for you that at the end of this meeting, you will gain acceleration. You will gain acceleration. You will beat time and season and supersede time and season because you have waited. Because you have waited. Because you have waited, you go far and beyond. Above those who have gone far, receive acceleration. Receive acceleration. Receive acceleration. Receive acceleration. Receive acceleration. Receive it now. Those of you on the line, receive it now. If you are looking for healing, be accelerated. If you are looking for deliverance, be accelerated. If you are looking for promotion, be accelerated. Everything you trust God for, be accelerated. Be accelerated. From today, I accelerate your success. I accelerate your success. I accelerate your healing. I accelerate your deliverance. I accelerate your restoration. Receive it now. Receive your miracles. Receive your miracles. Receive your miracles. Receive your miracles. In the name of Jesus. God, you are healed. God, you are delivered. God, you are restored. In the name of Jesus.
Jesus. Thank you,
precious Father. Be thou exalted. Be thou glorified.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Clap for Jesus. Sorry, I took your time.